Hi guys, it's your friendly neighbourhood Wongo ShortPlay playing Atomic Runner for the Sega Mega Drive. Now, this game was also known as Chelnov, which is the n- I was wondered why, but it's the name of the character. I know that now because I've seen the story six, maybe more times, because I am having a technical nightmare recording this game, and to be honest, it's not a good enough game to warrant any kind of fun at this point. First few times it was nicely surprising when I realised there was a lot more depth to it than I expected it to be, but we'll go into that in a minute. But after a while it's just getting annoying. Now, it's basically a runner, and I'd never played it back in its day, but having worked on lots of iPhone games in my time and played lots of Endless Runners and worked on lots of Endless Runners, I've kind of grown to hate Endless Runners, mainly because there was none of this actual exposition and story and design to the game, a consistent design. It was all about randomizing your encounters I am actually playing it now. Very, very badly. Randomising your encounters and upping the difficulty arc as you go along. And it was all about the game, which, fair enough, games kind of should be. But I think games should also have substance and kind of depth to them. And design to them. That's just a personal preference. I'm not saying anyone who likes Endless Runners is wrong. I just never really got into them. Oh, silly Michael, don't trip over things, boy. Now, wrong button. This is where this game starts to fall down. Now, it looks like an Endless Runner. It's a lot more complex. It's a three-button control Endless Runner. Usually, an Endless Runner, I've said those words too many times, it has an automated run forward, and then the player is able to hit a button to say jump. With me? Now, Chelnov, or Atomic Runner, has three buttons, and it also makes things more complicated than they need to be. Button A, jumps. Kind of cool, you can jump on heads as well. Ah, oh, I've just fallen prey to that complicating thing again. I'll tell you about that in a sec. Button B, shoots. Oh, that was silly. Let's have another go while I explain it. It's one of those games. One of those games. Yeah, chews you up and spits you out. Okay, so button B shoots. Button A jumps, button B shoots. There's no control over the height of the jump. You just jump really high. So you've got to kind of time your jumps quite well. There's no holding it down, you know. Button B shoots, and you can also move up diagonally, and you can duck, and you can kind of see how that works. Now, that would be kind of cool if the game was designed around those controls. But then you've got Mr. Turny Round button, button C, and funny little walk backwards animation, which is kind of fun. But that's where the fun ends, because by adding that turnaround animation, they've necessitated the use of that turnaround animation, especially later in the game. I've got quite far before now, believe it or not, without even using it. In fact, I'll try and do that now. But by including that animation, they've necessitated that animation, which means the game gets ridiculously difficult if you can't turn around, if you don't sort of train yourself to be able to turn around. Thing again. Now, that's kind of cool. Right now, it's all fine and dandy, and we can get about and do stuff and kick butts and take names and all good. But the turnaround isn't just a case of hitting the C button. No, no. You've also got to commit by pressing in the direction you want to go. Hit C and press in the direction you want to go. Now, that really doesn't sound too bad, but in a game that moves this fast, it really complicates things. You've got to hit your control and then commit your control. I'll let that sink in. You hit your C button and then you press left or right. There's no need for that. You could just tap C to turn around and that would be alright. And I would probably like this game a lot more for it. Still a decent game. It's really, really challenging. It's damn difficult. A little gripe is that enemy bullets move too fast for my liking. You know, I think I mentioned it before in some of the other shooters I've been talking over. Oh, that was a nice little hole. Oh, check that out. I love all the power-ups. Yeah, a little gripe in your average shooter is that occasionally. See, I'm getting confused with the buttons I want. That's a boss, isn't it? But yeah, you occasionally want a bit of bullet hell. If the bullets move too fast, the game's not fair. It's alright if you can see the bullet, but if you don't get a chance to see the bullet before it kills you, that's not fair, and that's what I object to. And this game does that, and that really sucks. The turnaround thing should just be a tap of C, not a tap and turn. Maybe later on there's a reason for that, but man, I hate that. Other than that, it's not a bad game. It's much better than the endless runners you get now, because it's not an endless runner. It just kind of looks like one until you realise it's a well-designed game. With level bosses, as we just kind of saw, can't be bad. Yeah, if you're into that, definitely check it out. Atomic Runner, Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.